If you spoil some shit, I'm better.
Then don't ask me.
But then do gas, bro.
It's not crazy. The fuck, man.
The fuck.
Fuck, man.
Fuck Xavier. Shit. Guess what? Guess what? Guess what? Who cares, big head?
Old friends are turning to strangers. Ex-lovers mad that I'm famous. They see the picture I painted. I've been going through changes. I pray to God and I made it. Nobody did me no favors. I'm sorry if you can't take it. I've been going through changes.
Warning, the video you're about to see is for people over the age of 13.
So if you're under 13, click out now, or in fact, don't watch this video or any of the videos on this channel.
With that being said, anyone over the age of 13, please enjoy our videos.
Yeah. What's up, y'all?
Back for the second episode.
Yo, episode one was crazy, bro.
I was like, are you fucking serious?
Yeah,
it was pretty funny, bro.
You already know damn well we're gonna be reacting as much episodes as we can today, because today might be our last day chilling for a while, and we'll spring down in another video.
Nah, we won't. We could just easily sit here because of the whole damn COVID-19 coronavirus bullshit. Okay, it's not bullshit. It's pretty serious, to be honest.
So serious that we're not even working for the time being.
Come on, we ain't Vanessa Hudgens. We ain't gonna be like making.
Yeah, what was the deal on that? I don't even know what she's going through.
Because she tried to talk about coronavirus like a fucking middle schooler.
I think that apology she made was kind of petty.
People are gonna die. It's just terrible, but like inevitable. I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't be doing this right now.
Well, her second apology was better. I'll give her that.
It was written, not a video, though.
But I'm not gonna be mad at her for the rest of her life.
Right. Everybody does dumb shit. Right. Some of them got fired out of it, and then they come back.
Yeah, come on, man.
Let's, and also, our prayers go to whoever has been affected. Bro, that's crazy. And for those who are still going to work under this condition, stay safe. Good job.
Wash your hands.
Obviously. Take care of yourselves and others. And just be safe out there, alright?
Yeah.
We really wish for all y'all the best.
And my grandmas and cousins out there who work in the hospitals. Alright, my prayers out to you, fam. I love y'all.
I guess I wanted to make an update video, but I guess I could say it here. We here in the Yurgen family, we will continue making videos. Like,
we'll
now
try,
it'll be
at least.
Oh no, I think it'll be more likely now that we're kind of out of a job for a while.
I mean, remember social distancing.
Yeah, I know, but like this is our last day to do new videos. But I still got plenty of videos
on my phone, so
you guys will definitely see a lot of content.
So whatever older videos we have, we're gonna try to push those out.
It'll be as old as somewhere, I guess, summer of last year. So stay tuned.
Since the Quiet Place is pushed back, I guess I can work on that video.
Damn, all those movies been pushed back. We're gonna talk about that in a separate video, but
yeah,
damn, all
that's
those
what
movies,
we, that's
though.
What we, man. It's crazy. That's what we do, man.
That's what we do.
It's
we add to new movies,
it's
bro.
It's affecting our movie life, bro.
Even the TV shows, the new episodes are getting delayed and shit.
I was ready to go see A Quiet Place in theaters.
Any movie that came out this month is kind of failing right now because not a lot of people
because
are going
to the coronavirus.
I know. And after today, you're not going to see us together for quite some time. We might just do that thing, that experiment video we did with Black Widow reaction, the first one, and just film ourselves reacting to stuff on ourselves.
Pretty much.
You think so?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah. But enough sadness, let's go back to more reaction, because there's only so much time we have to do today.
Alright, so we're gonna cut from here. This is basically our coronavirus discussion. That's it.
Yeah.
Five minutes too.
Oh, nice. I can make that a little update video. Okay.
Alright, ready? We're done. Ready?
Alright, we're gonna. Now we cut to the real thing.
Oh, what the hell, man?
Yep.
Alright, episode two, baby. 3, 2, 1.
I can't wait to use this music in the soundtrack.
Please be little Ricky, God. Please be little Ricky.
My question is, how far is he at? Where he is? Oh, is that
Thing's house?
Oh.
NCIC is clean. Although your daddy's credit's a little dirty.
Oh, that's why. That explains why his family is under
debt.
Damn it. Should have known this show will also be held liable to have corrupted cops in their show.
Come on. I mean, no disrespect to the police out there, but let's be real.
I guess it was bound to happen.
And Shelly? Here, why here?
Because she doesn't.
And she don't want to be
caught while showering.
She doesn't. Call me if I can dress you.
That explains the outfit.
I thought they were already paid when we first reacted to it.
Yeah.
Oh.
Caesar, bullshit. Little Ricky. I don't know. Maybe that's not Little Ricky.
Then who is that? Someone random then?
Oh, maybe that's their dad.
There's a dude toasted up outside.
Oh!
What's up?
Who is that? My father.
Boom. Called it.
Great job, Nuno.
Where have you been all night? I have to get ready for work.
You can't do that in the other room? Jesus Christ. Yeah, this guy's never gonna have his own room. That sucks, bro.
This man's got an AirPod already. Even Jamal got better AirPods than I do.
They should assume that I'm in charge. Why?
Why are
because
you in charge?
Because I found Homeworld money alone. Say I'm your daddy.
I'm not my
daddy. Oh yeah, Moreno. Nobody's in charge. It's just, an investigation, bro.
I'm the VP of VPX.
But that would make her the president.
You should say you're the president of VPN. Yeah, bro, stop thinking about who's in charge, bro. Chill out. Oh, there she is again.
That only makes sense. He got the AirPods, she got the retro scooter. I need to get a retro scooter right there.
So when did you get out?
Oh, he was arrested.
Yesterday. On a bounty. Seriously?
You think Spooky scared of him?
Yes.
It's nice to see you.
Well, probably not. He's probably pissed off. Probably my dad, man. I'd be fucking
pissed.
I'd be afraid to see him. I probably wouldn't even look at him. Oh, wait. Depends on what he did. Like, is it because, like, he was gone for so long?
I don't know. But I think we're about to find out since he's kicking him out for a reason.
Want to hang after school? Sure.
Yeah, at least he's making an effort to try to speak to his sons.
You are feeling uncomfortable because you are covering up.
Damn! I'm glad she's over 20.
Now she is. Damn.
Camel toe
is the new cleavage.
I really cannot believe she's over 30. That's very hard to believe.
Because all these guys are checking her out.
Oh. Ooh, wait, no, they're not.
No, they're not.
Badge before badge.
What before what?
Badge before badge.
Badge before badge.
Just looking.
Wow. Yeah. How the fuck is that girl 32? How?
I don't know.
She
so that means she was in her mid-20s when she was in that little Disney Channel show.
They say black don't crack, Asian don't raise them. Shit, what does that make us? Because like, we barely age too.
Let's get something straight.
First of all, those two.
You can come back here and pretend to be your father, but I know what's up. Is Caesar hate me? He's never even talked about you.
Probably didn't know you about your existence.
All these years and he never asked about him.
There you go, Jasmine.
Okay, why are you wearing...
He could have just said co-leader. How the fuck is she 32? She looks like a high schooler.
No! I mean, maybe she's crushing on you.
Wow. You would say anything to keep me from meeting
you? Yeah, go get some... Go get some popo.
Yeah, besides, I mean, she was a prophet. Wouldn't you think that she'll be going towards Caesar instead of Jamal? I mean, sure, Jamal was the one who found the roll of money.
Yeah, that's what I was about to say. Jamal's the one who found the roll of money.
But Caesar...
Either way, even if he's not affiliated with the Santos, he's connected.
Yeah, but Caesar and his brother, Spooky, was the ones who got all the prophets rested. He had no idea what was going on. All he did was found the prophet money, so... Don't you think that she wouldn't be going towards him if she was like after him?
But remember, Latrell knew about the relationship between Caesar and Marcy.
I got another theory. Maybe she's related to Latrell.
Okay.
When she found out that his brother got arrested.
Maybe she's not a prophet at all.
But I can. That's a nice car. And that is a great neighborhood. Look at that. Look at
let the girls go. He doesn't even know who the girls are. Damn that ass. He knows you two. It would be better if those two went instead.
But he's seen all of them already.
Too late. Yeah, he has now.
Yo. So guys, you think we
the... Yo, this is the one right here. This is the one.
What?
Huh?
The political uncle?
I'm the one. I'm the one.
Exactly.
and once we're inside his house, he'll take my instrument and release his fiddle into my awaiting house.
What?
What?
What? To be honest, I did this. Like, what?
I'd love to get in this. We need you for getting.
Oh no, that's my never now.
Actually, kind of even worse.
What are you guys doing?
Watching All My Black.
Making a video?
Yeah.
All right. What movie is this?
On My Block, it's a show.
On My Blood?
Block.
All On My Block.
Damn, that's a lot of food.
You know, there's an organization called My Block, My Hood, My City. Three for the stripes. Choices,
right? You didn't hear it from us.
Yay.
Just say you won't come in.
Well, yeah.
Riverdale?
No, On My... Dog, bro, don't disrespect the show like that. That's On My Block.
Hey, Riverdale's a good show.
Riverdale's better
Tell
than
me one Latino. I don't know, it's not.
One Latino, Veronica Lodge.
Oh, yeah, that's right. But all this is mainly Latino. It's based on our culture.
Yeah, I know.
And our hood.
Still, Latinos play a game in the show.
You think like we can start ranting and actually pay attention to this? Because yeah, I'm missing them real details.
Yeah, this is just the character development. He's trying to bond his dad.
I don't give a shit. I still want to pay attention. Oh, it's lucky for you. I'm going to binge watch this after. Oh, shit. Who's watching? Oh.
Grandma.
Ah, yes.
Welcome back, Grandma. Hey, yo. This is our grandma right here.
No.
His medical bills?
Oh, damn.
He got shot.
You're bouncing, and don't forget to play. Why don't you let Abuelita do the thing?
Team Jamal forever! Team Jamal is over.
Come on, y'all can't be divided and then try to solve a case.
Probably best Jamal left.
Nah, just like solve it together. Just join
yeah, besides, he really hates Jamal, so anyone that's not Jamal is good.
Yeah, just enjoying the best barbecue in town.
Point,
this is my father.
Oh no.
At least he owns a business, right? Rich
man. Hey, I know you. I was a senior when you were a freshman.
Really?
Former head of the Prophets, former head of the Santos.
Nah, I don't think he's a prophet at all.
No, he was, until he changed good things.
Was he?
Yeah, he mentioned that last season.
Okay, fine.
How's it going?
Morenos versus us. Hey, yo, guys, listen up. Morenos and Latinos, peace. We're peace up again.
Fuck, I got no more chips.
2 hours late.
Oh shit.
Why are you looking at me?
Put on your uniform and get to work.
You're gonna get that ass whooping rated.
Let's just go and I'm going.
Backwards. No.
Find a bush.
Hey yo, I gotta say, Jeremy got a good sense of style. Ew.
A loogie contest.
A loogie, ew. Nasty. Hey yo, you know what my grandpa calls it? A loogie.
Let's go.
Hey, let's go.
Oh, is that Tino Spit?
How'd you get that?
I was a guerrilla in La Guerra Sucia.
Ew!
I can get a lot of that, man.
Wow, please, Grandma just got all of that shit done without y'all. You know, she should solve the whole case right now.
Yeah, Abuelita is the gangster. He's gonna find a random gnome in there, isn't he?
Why would there a gnome get at his job?
I think that's the girl.
How'd you get his number? You're fired. Nah, just kidding. He can't fight the same thing.
Kendra.
I know the guys on my job.
Never mind, she's not crushing on him.
Oh, maybe that's. Get it?
Okay, now I'm confused. Did she want to fuck him up or did she want to fuck him?
My money's on fuck him.
To the grill.
Now I'm not Jamal.
Okay, not Jamal. You're fired.
You're fired. Which is it? Did she want to fuck him or kill him?
He got fired from his job.
Well, that was his father, though. His own father fired him.
Did you just say I'm fired?
Oh, yep.
So you finally decided to listen? I am sick and tired of your privilege.
My people have been kept down.
He's pulling the card.
Not to mention a terrible employee.
Chicken fingers. I don't even want to know where you have dipping sauces.
That's right. What? You don't.
And Caesar has sex up in here.
What?
Oh,
Blues.
No, sir. No good.
Nah, he fucked around that table. I bet.
You're dumb. Mean.
He can't say shit.
Add this to the funny Jamal compilation.
Caesar, we're quitting.
Nope. He's like, fuck you, I'm staying right here.
God, he's funnier in this season.
I know, I'm kind of a bit pissed that you watch it with all of them. He'll be
That's
back.
That's your dad, you idiot.
He'll be back.
There we go.
Hey, we, I got a pause. I got a pause.
Why?
Yo, I can't. I have to. I need a breather. It's too much.
It's not even that funny.
It was that funny, bro.
Okay, yeah, but.
Yo, and the dad was all like, as long as it wasn't in the produce section. So he had his back. He's like, I don't care if you fuck. Just don't do it on the food.
But that's still considering doing fucking where it's supposed to be graded A for health. When they get a black light, they still need to see like many little cum shots and shit. Nasty ass.
But how do you know he can't, where he can't, he probably can't in her, not on her.
Bro, you still believe that theory, bro? I really don't want you to be right on that. I don't want that to be the damn cliffhanger.
It doesn't have to be. All right, but I'm not holding my breath on it. But I'm definitely not gonna drop it though. That's a humongous possibility.
All right, look, we got 6 more minutes left. Can we please continue the episode, fam? All
right, now 25:45. Oh, sorry, I needed a breather, bro.
I feel like besides Abuelita, no one of their family members know that they're like in line with a very dangerous
that's friendship right there.
Well, it's definitely improving since season one. Well, but you've been through a lot of shit too. Actually, all y'all's been through a lot of shit. Not one person has been through more shit than the other.
I mean, one literally got shot in the chest. The other one got chased down by a gang.
I guess this season will be the one to happen. Something serious happened with Jamal. Cause so far it's just that girl hunting him down. You still miss your mom?
That's fine. I mean, you can still miss your mom. Like, you wish she was better. It's not racist.
Wait, did Jasmine mention what happened with her mother?
I don't think, yeah. But I'm dropping my old theory. Maybe her mom is dead or some shit.
That's crazy for Jasmine. Her mom might be dead and her dad's paralyzed. Oh yeah, Nuno. Dewey was a shitty mistake with did thinking that her dad was someone else, but we forgot that last season they literally showed us her dad. Yeah, Jasmine's dad.
Man.
Yeah, we were
yeah,
dumb.
I realized that after I binge watched it.
But what I don't got is your hairy ass up against my back. I need some space.
I don't even know her ass is hairy. She's talking to her mom. Oh, nope, she's talking to Caesar.
Uh-oh.
He didn't get him a job. Thing got him a job. What's his name? Yeah, Jamal's dad got him a job.
Okay. Press menu, I want to hear that song.
But,
I love the soundtrack. What you mean number two? Bitch, that should be number one. Who the fuck's number one? Show me what number one is right now.
I honestly don't know, but yo, seriously, damn, yo, now that we're getting into the feels up in here.
You think we might actually finish the whole season tonight?
I don't know, but damn, I was freaking, that was fucking funny, yo. Fucking Jamal. Hey, yo, he tried to call out everybody else, but not everybody was doing bad things like he did. Like, he's coming in late all the time, like, and he's always...
He's finally facing up the consequences. This season really gonna show Jamal finally getting the punishment he deserves in a way. I mean, we don't want him to get punished like that, but the show writers definitely know that Jamal isn't gonna be going all free and shit, free and easy all this time.
I mean, come on. Yeah, his pops was talking about how some of us youngins are spoiled and shit. Like, yes, I'm tired of your privilege.
He's and
like,
we know about
privilege,
that.
Privilege.
Obviously,
man,
they
people have
and it shows. Well, we saw him with AirPods. We seen him with other products and shit.
Yeah, he's talking about how spoiled he is and like, that's kind of
and
how
he acts too. He was really acting, I'm the leader and shit because I found the World War money.
I mean, we ain't gonna deny it. Jamal is smart as hell.
Yeah, but he's like, very spoiled.
But the very little consequences that he got.
Bro,
yeah.
Jamal truly is a spoiled ass brat. We gotta agree with this.
But we
and being in the friend group in which most of his friends aren't that wealthy.
They just throw him off. they threw him off. Like, he's like, listen, I'm done with his group team, alright? Let's join forces. And freaking how crazy how grandma was able to get all the information like that.
And not only that, he tried to call out, be like, what about Caesar? He had sex.
And Caesar was like,
hmm? The way it was like, was it on the food? On the produce section? And he's like,
He's right, we chill.
So basically, you're allowed to. So basically, in Dwayne's, hey, I want to go work over there.
I bet he was like, nah, because me and the missus have been there too. We did it on the tables too.
Yo, Dwayne, call me, bro. I need a job right now.
You know, it'd be fucked up if Jamal, since Jamal was so pissed at his dad for firing him on the spot, wouldn't it be funny if he mentioned, you can't fire me. All right, don't you think I should still work here after what you and my mom did on my bed?
Oh, I see what you're getting at.
That would have made that funny.
That would have been even funnier. He's like, I got you on camera. Oh, wait, no. That'll make it worse.
As worse as Jasmine filming two minors having sex?
No. It'll be worse because his parents and getting caught on camera in his room, he probably get his ass beat. Shit, you know he's gonna get the belt, bro. I got the belt. Shit, but like,
oh, man. I'm really loving this season, bro.
Hey, yo, but seriously, Dwayne, call me, bro.
It only makes sense. I was kind of wondering. Why, I mean, before they showed the reveal who else was working there, that random chick, I was like thinking because there was like three people, Jamal, Caesar, and that random girl that Caesar had sex with that one time. Yeah. And then she left on the spot and it was just the both of them. And when he hired Caesar's dad and fired Jamal, I was about to say, like, why are you firing Jamal? Don't you need a third person? Then I saw the other person. I was like, oh, never mind. She's here.
And I don't even
want to
know. You stick the sauce. I'm like, yeah, yeah, no. Like, I'm like, what the hell is that supposed to mean?
I like how Caesar's reaction is like, bro, you putting me off the spot right there, bruh.
That's fucked up, bro. Never put your boy on the spot like that.
Yeah, I can't believe he put his boy on the spot and he couldn't mention like how he loves to snuggle with him when he was staying with him, remember?
And yeah, never put your boys on the spot. Yeah, I don't know. But we know. And we got Monse and Jasmine, they're talking about their family and shit.
Their friendship's going high, you know.
And Monse officially confirmed that them and Jasmine are official friends.
And she finally found another girlfriend after moving on from Ruby's unofficial stepsister.
Ooh.
You mean a
yeah. Nah, they were not related at all.
They're not blood.
They were not related whatsoever.
So my final conclusion is, once again, another great episode.
I give this 5 stars because that was so funny. I was gonna give it 4, but that was way too funny to not give it an extra star, bro.
I'll give it a 5.2, but however, I didn't find it as funny as Nuno, though. I don't know why. I guess I was kind of a bit distracted because of distractions.
Alright, we done here.
You about to watch episode 3 right now. You
stupid ass kid. He looks like stupid with a big ass head. Big ass fucking football head. He fucking throw his head, bro. She's bigger than a softball. No, I'm recording.
Say Brady can.
No.
I got some.
Oh, shit. I ain't trying to hear shit.
Say what? Say kiss who?
And watch that.